Good day, I'm your humble narrator, Sideways Thinker, and I'm just here with a brand new Let's Play. As the title suggests, but bizarrely, not the screen, suggests, today we are going to be playing Bioshock Infinite on that there PC. For those of you who are unaware, Bioshock Infinite is a first-person shooter created by, I believe the company's called Irrational Games, and published, I believe, by 2K. It was released in England on the 26th of March. I don't know about anywhere else in the world, but that's where it was released for me. As I say, it's a first-person shooter which is very narrative-driven. That's really all the introduction you need to the game itself. However, I am going to quickly point out right at the beginning that, two things. Number one, three things. Number one, shortly after its release, this game very quickly became my favourite first-person shooter, just beating out Bioshock 1, that is now my second favourite first-person shooter, with Bioshock Infinite standing just above it. As I said before, this game is very narrative-driven, so my apologies if I don't quite shut up in time when there's an important conversation going on or an important narrative thing occurring. I am going to try to make sure I be quiet for a lot of it, otherwise there's no point in watching this. It's a narrative-driven game, and though I always say that with Let's Plays, the point is the commentator, not the game. There's kind of a lot, there's a balance, and this one is definitely more about the narrative than anything else, so me shouting over that is very unfair. What else? Oh, yes, actually, no, I've wasted a bit too much time nattering on at the beginning. Let's just get into the game. So, there we go, play game. Oh, my apologies if the graphics are lower than you might expect, but of course, given how recent this game is, and given how much fraps eats the frame rate, in order to keep it at a decent frame rate, I have had to turn down. It's on low, basically. I've had to turn down a lot of the graphics options. Bizarrely, this is a game where the graphics options going down doesn't actually seem to be that big of an issue, so yes. This will overwrite, yep. I was only failing at 1999 mode. Of course, we're going to play on medium, because that's the generic way of playing the game. If I was a masochist, I'd play on 1999 mode, but I'm saving that for my second playthrough, though I have tried it and then gave up because I had a load of more games to play. Anyway, medium. Let's go. Actually, while it's loading, I have seen some utterly ridiculous reviews for this game. I saw one man who was bitching about it because it doesn't use its own game engine. He gave it like a 2 out of 10, saying it was an awful game because it doesn't use its own game engine. Absurd. Oh yes, here we go. Yes, I have the pre-order Industrial Revolution bonuses and also the season pass, so my machine gun and pistol are going to be a weird color, which is going to look odd because I use the pistol more than any other gun in the game, so yeah.
Booker, are you afraid of God?
No, but I'm afraid of you.
The mind of the subject will desperately struggle to create memories where none exist. Barriers to Transdimensional Travel. R. Lutes, 1889. Maine. Why is it always Maine?
Are you going to just sit there?
As compared to what? Standing?
Not standing. Rowing.
Rowing? I've planned on it.
So you expect me to shoulder the burden?
No. I do expect you to do all the rowing.
And why is that?
Coming here was your idea.
My idea?
I made it very clear that I don't believe in the exercise.
The rowing?
No. Imagine that's wonderful exercise.
Then what?
The entire thought experiment.
Excuse me. How much longer?
One goes into an experiment knowing one could fail.
But one does not undertake an experiment knowing one has failed.
Can we get back to the rowing?
I suggest you do, or we're never going to get there.
No, I mean I'd greatly appreciate it if you would assist.
Perhaps you should ask him. I imagine he has a greater interest in getting there than I do.
I suppose he does, but there's no point in asking.
Why not?
Because he doesn't row.
He doesn't row?
No, he doesn't row.
Ah, I see what you mean.
It's only in the lower graphic settings that you actually notice that they've actually that doesn't actually appear to be a lighting effect on his face. They've actually textured his face darker, so you can't tell who he is. Clever bastards.
Shall we tell him when we'll be returning?
Would that change anything?
No.
It might give him some comfort.
At least that's something we can agree on.
Hey! Somebody meeting me here?
I'd certainly hope so.
It does seem like a dreadful place to be stranded.
A gentleman and a lady. Lovely. Right, well, here we are, finally in control, though not properly. And I think if we keep watching these two, they are just going to stop. I think they do just, like, stop moving at some point and just kind of sit there. Oh, that, or they just stop rowing. Nah, it looks like I'm wrong. Yeah, it looks like I'm wrong. I could have sworn they just stopped moving at some point. Maybe that was a bug. Right, so, here we are, and any of you who are familiar with Bioshock 1 will recognize this shit, because it is always fucking lighthouses. Hang on, have they stopped out there? Have they just stopped really far away? I think they might have stopped. But, yes. Bioshock Infinite. It's always main, and it's always lighthouses. Okay. Why is it that lighthouses, when they feature in fiction, are predominantly foreboding? Holy shit, I can go around here. Is there anything for me to pick up, or... Oh, cool. Cool, some cash that I didn't notice before. But, yeah, why is it that lighthouses are predominantly foreboding in any appearance in fiction? It's only in very, like, kids' stories or in really trashy, awful books that you find lighthouses that aren't supposed to be threatening. I mean, fucking look at that! Look! That's clearly threatening.
Excuse me. It's Booker DeWitt. I guess you're expecting me?
Well, how the fuck was that door sealed if he could slam on it that hard and then gently push it aside? Oh, I love this song.
It's good enough for me.
Yep, and there's our character, Booker DeWitt.
Good luck with that, pal.
Of thy sins I shall wash thee. From Sodom shall I lead thee.
Is anyone here? Hello?
Religion, the old time religion, is good enough for me. Dying. It's good when I am dying. It's good when I am dying. And it's good enough for me. The old time religion. The old time religion.
I keep trying to find a link on YouTube to just like that song. Just the full one and that version.
Time religion. The old.
I think it stops if you stay here.
The old time religion is good enough for me.
Yeah, it's done now. Right, enough singing, back to searching. Although, really, I don't know. There's blood on that table. What did someone bash a guy's head off the table? While he appeared to be eating what appears to be a mixture of potatoes and shit? Terrible life working in a lighthouse.
To thine own land shall I take thee.
Oh, it seems there's a Dark Brotherhood sanctuary nearby. I can't be the only person who thinks that looks like it's on fire. Oh dear! Oh my.
Shit.
You know what, that is a fair enough statement. When you see that, you're entirely justified in just going, oh, fucking hell. What is it with the games I've been playing recently and notes? Like, foreboding notes. And dead people.
In New Eden soil shall I plant thee. Porthole.
Can't get in that. Wait, did it actually let me try? No, it was just the sound of my footsteps. By the way, you can't see shit out here, even if you have the Drawdistance on very far, because let's fuck all out here! Silver Eagle, despite the fact that that amount of them is completely negligible, even early in the game. Right, so, here we have a lighthouse, and a rather curious-looking contraption, with a scroll, a key, and a saber written on some bells, and what appears to be an angel with George Washington's face.
Wait a minute, that card.
You know, I remember when I first played this, I was like, that's a bit bad, isn't it? Showing up with a, literally giving us a card with the puzzle response on it. But then again, first thing you do in the game, really. If you're gonna put a puzzle at the beginning of the game, might as well make it simple.
What in the world is...
How fucking terrifying must this look to the people in Maine? They're all tucked up in bed, and then they look out the window, and all they see is, like, lights coming from there, and then the sky lighting up in a red, hellish flame. I don't know about you, but when I saw this first, UFOs, that's what I thought, that's all I could think of. Strange lights in the sky, aliens coming down. Also, I don't think they ever fully explain why the sky does that. It does seem like a bit much.
All right. Looks like they expect me to sit in their fancy chair.
It's not that fancy, really. It also doesn't look that comfortable. I'm not in dentistry. Especially the manacles, but then again, maybe my dentist is just mental. I don't know.
Make yourself ready, Pilgrim. The bindings are there as a safeguard.
There we realize that Booker DeWitt's head can spin 360 degrees.
No, God damn it!
Attention. Ascension in the count of 5.
Here we get to see Booker do it again a couple of times when the electricity flashes on his face.
15,000 feet. Hallelujah.
This, my friends, is what I call a beautiful opening vista. Incredible. Beautifully done, masterfully executed. Father Comstock always reminds me of someone, but I can never put my finger on what he looks like. He looks like something, but I can't quite put my finger on it. If anyone knows, if anyone has a guess as to what it is that he reminds me of, tell me. Why would he send his savior unto us, if we will not raise a finger for our own salvation? And though we deserve not his mercy, he has led us to this new Eden. A last chance for redemption. Red Dead Redemption, sorry. So, when I said Red Dead Redemption, I just turned, looked at my video game collection, and realised that my PS3 collection has been horribly badly advertised because Red Dead Redemption inexplicably comes before Catherine. Sorry. And the prophet shall lead his people to the new Eden. Can I get that out, please? Can't imagine those. Yeah, there we go. I can't imagine those are particularly comfortable. And control again. And I'm fairly certain that that objective noise is the same one you got in Bioshock 1. Book, the word of the prophet. They use that book a lot. Which to me, always, whenever I see the word of the prophet, all I can think of is, what's it called? It's like sayings of Mao Zedong or something like that. Or phrases. It's something like that. It's very similar. He looks like something.
Seed of the prophet.
Seed of the prophet shall sit the throne and drown in flame the mountains of man. They fucking love that phrase in this game. Adore it, it's in everything. You know, I'm just gonna quickly set up a response here.
Excuse me, where am I?
Heaven, friend. Or as close as we'll see till Judgment Day.
I would hate to be wearing something like that in all this water. The bottom of that would be soggy as shit, and because it's like a one... Because it's like one robe, it would be very uncomfortable to walk in.
Unless I want to get paid.
I wonder if I had my textures high, if I could read that. Probably not. There's no way anyone would be able to read that in the game. And yes, we are literally just wandering through a chapel and nicking people's things. Quite why people are leaving things here, I don't know.
Gotta find the exit out of this place.
And here we have the new version of the audio diaries, the Voxophones.
Love the prophet because he loves the sinner. Love the sinner because he is you. Without the sinner, what need is there for a redeemer? Without sin, what grace has forgiveness?
That's odd. I would have thought I would have subtitled it, given that so much of the game's narrative is told through those things. Well, anyway, it's fully my intention to shut the fuck up whenever I'm playing those things, mostly because I like hearing them as well, but because I don't want to bugger it up for people. Oh, also, something else I should say while we're just kind of wandering around ransacking things. As several people pointed out during my System Shock videos, I tend to miss things, so if I do miss things in the Let's Play, my apologies, but there is kind of a certain level of haste that, applies when you are recording something for YouTube. So I will, just because I'm gonna play this mostly the way I played it the first time, but with a bit more of an exploration, because I want to find everything, because I didn't on my first go through. And you can't really on 1999 mode, because enemies keep... Because, you know, the enemies keep killing you. Oh, bloody hell.
On this day of days, we recommit ourselves to our city and to our prophet, Father Constantine.
I'm just going to talk over because I was mid-sentence and there's quite a long talk of seeing come after this and I don't think he shuts up. Right, but yes, my apologies if I do miss things. Just getting out of the way right at the beginning.
And not railed against the Sodom beneath us, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just railed against the Sodom beneath us, but not accepted the 3 golden gifts of the founders, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just accepted the 3 golden gifts of the founders and not prayed for our deliverance, it would have been enough. If the prophet had only prayed for our deliverance and not led us to this new Eden, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just led us to the new Eden and not purged the vipers of the Orient, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just purged the vipers of the Orient, but not suffered the sacrifice of his beloved, it would have been enough. If the prophet had just suffered the sacrifice of his beloved, but not expelled the Vox Populi, it would have been enough.
That is one thing about this game that drives me insane. It's a very small OCD thing, but everyone calls them the Vox Populi, when I've always been, as far as I'm aware, it should have been pronounced the Vox Populi. I don't know which one's correct, but I'm assuming I am, because, you know, genius over here. No, just because you kind of, you got to agree with yourself, haven't you?
Is it someone new? Someone from the Sodom below? Newly come to Columbia to be washed clean before our prophet, our founders, and our lord.
I just need passage into the city.
Passage to the city. Brother, the only way to Columbia is through rebirth in the sweet waters of baptism. Will you be cleansed, brother?
Good God, these people are creepy.
Let's either this or turn around and get back on that rocket. Might as well get it over with.
Hey.
A very creepy looking priest.
I baptize you in the name of our prophet, in the name of our founders, and the name of our Lord. I don't know, brothers and sisters, but this one doesn't look clean to me.
He just flat out drowns him.
Who's there? Who's there?
Bring us the curb and wipe away the debt!
What do you want?
We had a deal to it. Open this door right now!
I told you! I'm not gonna do it! Go away!
Mr. DeWitt! Mr. DeWitt!
Good God, this man lived in a fucking shithole.
Where'd you go to the toilet?
Fine, you bastard. What do you want? Oh. Oh, it's Armageddon! Okay. It's the apocalypse. Ragnarok! Doomsday! Okay. Oh, look at me when I'm like 60.
No, because our pride
can't be
outside. Oh, no, that idiot priest needs to learn the difference between baptizing a man and drowning
one. She granted a sword of gold, so that
I need to find a landmark and figure out where the hell I am.
Above all other nations.
To Father Franklin, a key of gold so that Eden might have industry that set her above all other nations.
To Father Jefferson, a scroll, so that Eden might have laws that set her above all other nations.
And so each year we recommit ourselves to our founders and our prophet, Father Comstock.
And recommit to our prophet, Father Comstock.
So that we may follow in the prophet's path.
Amen.
Yes, they follow a very, very bizarre version of the Judeo-Christian Abrahamic faiths in which Jesus doesn't seem to matter, and these chappies are, you know, obviously you got George Washington, Benjamin Franklin, and Thomas Jefferson, I think? I'm not particularly good on American history. Who are the Jesus figures. Oh, it only just occurred to me, if you look at his health, he did actually suffer some damage from being drowned. Okay, I didn't notice that. I didn't know that happened. But yes, it's all a bit weird, and the dogs are going fucking mental. Give me a moment. Sorry about that. My brother came in, and my dog Bronson tends to throw a fucking shit fit whenever he sees my brother. He screams like a fucking banshee. I don't know whether or not the microphone picks it up, but given the other weird shit that this microphone's managed to pick up in the past,
Our prophet fills our lungs with water, so they may better love the air.
I'm fairly certain that that guy who drowned me wasn't the fucking prophet. I'm fairly certain he was a madman who was half blind.
He who crossed the Delaware with flaming sword and wings of angels. Watch over me and lend me strength. Shield my mind from fear and doubt so that I may hold fast against all invaders. Father Washington, hear my prayer.
They do have a pretty lax entry requirement, don't they? Find the lighthouse with the rocket in it, and you can get in. Okay.
Man of virtue, a rebel against ignorance and tyranny. Share with me your wisdom, and let the light of your good judgment shine like a beacon through the darkness. Father Jefferson, hear my prayer.
By the sword,
and the scroll, and the key.
Amen.
Fairly certain this dude right here had the same voice actor as half of the Dark Elves in Skyrim. Which is fine by me. I really like the Dark Elves in Skyrim. I always play Dunmer.
No luck, only providence. And that you see its divine hand at work, you discern the transmundane. Your inspiration and imagination transcend mere science and open our eyes to the mystery. Father Franklin, hear my prayer.
I remember I was talking to my good friend Dark Chiron about this game, because he completed it recently, and he said that it strikes him as very bizarre that, of all people, Benjamin Franklin...
Just because the city flies don't mean it ain't got its fair share of fools. All right. Still got a girl to find.
But yeah, of all people, Benjamin Franklin would be revered in this crazy religion, because Benjamin Franklin, as far as I'm aware, was a fairly rational, scientifically minded man. I'm just gonna have to keep going until we hit a checkpoint. Because this game does not... I just moved my mouse mat so my head went fucking mad. I'm not gonna stand here listening to these people on this floor.
Good to see you. I bet we can have something ringing. Perfect day for the celebration.
Armstrong must have foreseen and planned it just this way.
Yeah, there's ever so slightly, you probably picked up on it already, but there is ever so slightly a massive psychotic cult of personality surrounding Mr. Comstock here.
That statue. I just think it fails to capture Father Comstock's absolute divinity.
Cult of personality, it's creepy.
Does not matter to a Liberty Scout. There's no room for preference, only duty.
That's not disturbing.
Saltonstall's all right, I tell you. Says he's for faith, family, and fatherland. Who could be against all that?
I can. Also, I swear to God that this setup of NPCs standing in this way with those models are in every other scene in the game. It's always this dude trying to convince this woman to date this guy. You know, it's always the same three. It's slightly weird. I'm not even sure if it's meant to be the same people, because they seem to have different voice actors at times.
Never hire an artist, my dear fellow. They are a temperamental and unreliable lot to a man. I told him that the park is exceedingly far behind schedule. The landscaping is half finished. The statuary hasn't arrived. The fountain is full of rainwater, for God's sake. Even the marigolds are still unplanted.
Yeah, that guy's just being incredibly uptight. Right. I'm just going to talk over him again. Because there's a lot of conversations that happen in the background, which at times can be interesting, and if it's one that I think it is interesting, I will shut up. But this guy is just being an entitled fuck spot.
You almost finished down there?
Yes, sir.
But yeah, so here we have the kinetoscopes. It's just a little silent film. Just watch. You find these dust around the landscape. There's an achievement finding all of them. Also, maddeningly, they subtitled the silent film. Look, they've subtitled that. I don't know why. I don't know what fucking smart ass thought that would be a good idea. Yeah, those tend to just kind of tell little stories about the history of Columbia. Actually, we're going to hear the words of Zachary Hale Comstock.
And then the Archangel showed a vision. A city, lighter than air. I asked her, why do you show this to me, Archangel? I'm not a strong man. I'm not a righteous man. I am not a holy man. She told me the most remarkable thing. You're right, Prophet. But if grace is within the grasp of one such as you, how can anyone else not see it in themselves?
It's kind of an interesting juxtaposition that you can look at that statue when listening to his first voxophone, when he's being very humble, and then you look at this thing. It's like a 20-foot-tall, 30-foot-tall statue of himself holding a sword with a Cthulhu-y beard. I remember... Oh, God, the frame rate's acting up. But, yes, I remember thinking that when the first trailers came, I remember thinking, ooh, there might be a bit of a Lovecraftian bent because his beard looked like tentacles, but no, it's just he had a weird beard. Side note, this alleyway looks a bit foreboding. And, by the way, welcome to the menu screen!
Good day, citizen. You're looking fit.
That is a very odd thing to say. A very odd thing. Electronic horses. Right.
After the victory and wounded knee, the Angel Columbia did present herself.
Religion! Alright. All I can really say to that is just, religion! Religion, the clear supplanting of Christ with the Lamb. Because I believe they actually explained that she was supposedly of a virgin birth as well. Oh dear.
Warm temperatures.
Hello.
And light variable winds throughout the afternoon.
Oh, no, and here we have just a little touch where you can just nick silver eagles from there. I, however, will do no such thing. I will eat the cake. I will eat the whole cake in one bite. Booker's jaw will unhinge like a serpent and I will steal everything else. But then,
here you go.
I'll be kind and put in a silver eagle. Indeed.
Who is this girl?
The false shepherd seeks only to lead our lamb astray. Have a look at another kinetoscope. I love the kinetoscopes. Though the fact that they subtitle them is maddening. Here we have a nice little conversation that I always like. I'm not sure why.
Would you care for a boutonniere? We're raising money for the Girls Patriotic League.
Maybe next time.
You'd look dashing with one in your lapel. Come back if you change your mind.
Okay, I'm sorry. I need to go first. I need to go back there to get a Vox phone, but listen to this.
God only knows what I'd be.
I wonder if there's somewhere to download an MP3 of this. Because I'm fairly certain that, because as you know, this game takes place in 1912, but there's kind of a running motif of they seem to have music from the 60s onwards, inexplicably. Well, there is an explanation, but I can't really explain it at the moment because it's a bit spoilery if you haven't played the game yet. And, but yeah, I'm gonna have to look for that on YouTube now, see if there's an MP3 of that somewhere. Cheese! Scarf down the cheese, scarf down an apple. Get another Zachary Hale Comstock Vox phone.
One man goes into the waters of baptism, a different man comes out, born again. But who is that man who lies submerged? Perhaps that swimmer is both sinner and saint until he is revealed onto the eyes of man.
I always kind of hoped that this game would pull a stub of the zombie and have these guys with jetpacks become enemies near the end. No such luck. Wonder who I'm talking about? Go watch my stub as a zombie let's play. Self-promotion. Whoa.
That kind of talk draws attention.
Oh, don't turn into some finkton radical on me, John. I do not want to be some character out of I Married a Vox Populi. Now, do I?
Vox Populi. Oh dear. That's a bit foreboding.
Yeah, that's where they said I'd find her.
Telegram, Mr. DeWitt.
Huh.
Telegram for you, sir.
DeWitt, stop. Do not alert Comstock to your presence. Stop. Whatever you do, do not pick number 77. Stop. Lutess.
Oh, this is... Okay, this is a very cool thing that I only noticed on my second playthrough. No one there, right? Look through these. Why would you look at that? There appear to be a man and woman juggling. Anyone who's familiar with this game know who those are, and those of you who aren't will become familiar with them soon. But they are that. I just love that. Just a little touch. Didn't look away, not in there. But then if you try to see them again... Side note, the achievement for the kinetoscopes also applies, for some reason. These things, the binoculars, the telescopes, also apply to that. Oh, that's a bit suspicious looking. I report you to the authorities! What authorities? Hello? How are you doing? Come on, there's gotta be a
good day to you, sir.
Hello.
People are way too friendly.
Look at her. Ain't she some kind of beauty?
Statue.
No, that's where all the...
If I told you a man, the boys
take hello there, friend.
Morning, can I steal your popcorn? No. Fair enough. Let's go this way. Fuck the police!
Go
fuck it!
Through here, pal.
Streets closed for your safety, fella. They're prepping tonight's fireworks back there.
There's enough TNT back there to blow Peking to Kingdom Come. Again.
Roadblock. Better find another way around.
Fairly certain. Yeah, there isn't actually a road back there. It's not as much a roadblock as it is absence of road.
Sweet. And feats of wonderment are at the tips of your fingers. You know our prophet is fair. You know our prophet is kind. And he has asked, personally asked Mr. Jeremiah Fink to bring to you these amazing wonders.
Praise yes, be to as if you can't tell from the two devil-costumed fellows here, the Vigors that he's talking about are this game's replacement for Plasmids. Now, in an incredibly religious setting, I can't for the life of me figure out exactly why it is that you'd want to advertise your seemingly magic-level powers with, you know, people dressed as the frigging devil. It seems very strange. But yes, in this game, they didn't even attempt to explain where the Vigors come from. They just say, science and quantum and stuff. And then just kind of justify it like that, which is fair enough, because the plasmids in Bioshock 1 were kind of a core part of the setting, whereas in Infinite, they're not really important to the narrative. They're just kind of... They're just kind of there as a gameplay mechanic, so it's fair enough that it doesn't have that much of an explanation, because really, it doesn't require one. It's just... As long as it works mechanically and it doesn't seem too out of place,
young
it's fine.
Sir, young miss, roll up and try the amazing power of Bucking Bronco. Whether you need it lifted, lofted, tossed, or tumbled, Bucking Bronco is just the ticket.
And here we have several carnival games where
young
we can
sir,
ask around. There's
miss,
one there, one here, one over there, and there's also a Voxphone thing up there, and we'll check them all out because I think they're fun. Let us play, and we can get some rewards. Let us play Cast Out the Devil.
Young give it a shot.
Young miss, roll up and try the amazing power of Bucking Bronco.
Yes. Good to know that they could hire people with very good voices. Devil voices.
And there's devil number one.
Feel sorry for that guy. He's being hired to wear a stupid suit and then get this horrible
two.
Shit
Woo!
Fired at him.
And that's three. We have a winner.
Yay. I mean, you're giving it a lot of welly in the voice, but not so much in the face. Try better, huh? Okay, and here we have shotgun practice. And also kind of an introduction to the concept of the skylines. There's actually two. There's one over there that shows how they're supposed to be used, and there's one over here that shows how we use them. So, here we go. Air shotgun, which is just a shotgun, but let's call it an air shotgun. There we go. Shotgun Barker. Yeah, it's just a shotgun. Where are you, you bastard? This does seem like a very expensive carnival game. I mean, because it does involve a flat-out destruction of what appear to be wooden cutouts of blocks popular. Can you imagine? I mean, yeah, fair enough. They're the most expensive thing on the face of the earth. But at the same time, not going to be that cheap, are they? Damn it! Fucking hell, I've never gotten second place on that. I'm trying again. No, fuck.
I'm trying.
Yeah, fuck you. I always get first on this. I'm annoyed now. Ah, there we go. Some of me have to shoot. Okay, I get it now. Something I meant to say earlier, I don't fully understand this, I think you've probably noticed. This place has a fairly large population. How exactly did all these people get here if the only way in is a rocket, followed by baptism. Yeah, there we go, you bastards. Damn right I earned that. Fuck me. Oh, you can also do this, but I really don't think there's any point. I think you just can. Then again, this game has a lot of that. Just kind of little touches. Little things you can do. Right, so now let's...
Boxophones! Boxophones! Hear your voice from the past in the present!
Okay. Use this voxophone.
Say something, sonny.
What's a voxophone?
What's a voxophone?
Exactly that! A personal record of voice.
Hey, just so we're clear, I'm not paying for this.
Just a demonstration, sir.
You know, they could do better. Right.
Columbia, show your skill by hunting down Daisy Fitzroy and the vile members of the Vox Populi.
Pretty certain that's a carbine, which is good, because I like the carbines. Right, now let's do this. Get ourselves a couple more Silver Eagles, because, you know, you can never have too many. You know, you can never have too many. Side note, I can't help but feel this is going to be a very long first video, because I don't seem to be having too much luck with finding a checkpoint. Hey, first video on the Let's Play. Long one. That's kind of my rule. First one, the last one can be longer than usual. I don't know if you can actually hit Fitzroy more than once. I've tried before. There doesn't seem to be any point in it, though. Come on, let me get 25. Damn it, 24. Oh well. Got my prize. And here we have what has actually very quickly become kind of the famous enemy in the game. The handyman.
He's big, he's bold, he's the amazing handyman. Only in our fair city will you see such amazing feats of technological prowess.
I always kind of, whenever I see this, I always kind of feel sorry for the handyman, because he just seems very confused and scared and in pain.
Come
poor devil.
Down and see the amazing
have you ever seen anything like it?
He looks so sad.
Sad? When you're that strong, what's there to be sad about?
I don't know, the fact his entire body's been removed and he's now a fucking automata, maybe that?
Dear
okay.
Friend, have you ever lost a penny to a vending machine? Has a pay telephone ever refused to connect you with a beloved spouse? Well, it's time to take back control from the men of metal. With possession, you are the master. You will bend any machine to your will.
You're one of those.
I'll take a bottle.
Just a whisper. They're all ears.
Can't hear the phrase all ears without thinking of that one Doctor Who quote. Well, if you've got a better idea, I'm all ears. In fact, if you've got a better plan, I'll take you to a planet where everyone is all ears. Side note, for quite such a puritanical nightmare, this does seem ever so slightly risque for the time period. I mean, obviously, at the moment, there's nothing particularly risque at it from a current point of view, but just like this whole sales pitch and just the design of the bottle seems risque for the time, for the setting, you know? And yes, here we have what is genuinely my favorite vigor possession.
Your spot at the Raffle awaits.
Yeah, he wouldn't let us in.
I don't know why I didn't recognize you before. Odd.
The other one.
Always good to have gentlemen of your caliber at our fine fairgrounds.
And look, it's those chaps we saw through the binoculars.
Heads.
Or tails.
Come on, let me through. Heads.
Or tails.
Yeah, still a kind of
heads. Told you.
I
never find that as satisfying as I'd imagine.
Chin up, there's always next time.
I suppose there is.
So I know, I think we can actually just stand here and we'll start talking. These two are my favourite characters in the game.
You have my word on that.
Just gonna stand here and let her finish her cycle of words. Then she just starts beating
herself.
It does
show a certain lack of initiative. If you keep this up, I'll be forced to start repeating myself.
We won't leave until you do. You have my word on that.
You see, she actually points out that she's going to have to start repeating herself. I don't know why, I just like that.
You
I think it's a
nice
touch.
You don't have a certain lack of initiative.
Side note, I can't be the only this woman, I can't remember this voice actress's name, but she's got a very distinct voice. I can't remember who she is, though. I'm fairly certain she voiced Bastila in KOTOR. I may be wrong, but she does have a very distinct voice. Yeah, there's absolutely no point in arsing around with that guy at the moment.
Look at that one. He looks lost.
He looks just fine to me.
Mary, you are a living, walking scandal.
You two have the same face. It's creepy. Right. I think, is there another Vox phone out there? Am I remembering correctly? I think there is. Then again, I can't imagine these people would take too kindly to see me nicking things. Oh yeah, because that's not creepy or anything. Sing praise to the songbird, for he is the protector of the lamb.
My role model? My Lady Comstock, of course.
The prophet, bless her and keep her.
Nah, that's not. There's a lot of creepy things going on here.
This little beauty? The whole division got them. If we're going to flush the Vox out of the Skyline system, we got to have the best.
They got any openings in the group? I'd love to bust some Vox skull.
That's just fucking silly. Did that statue just... That statue just turned from that man to that woman. Our Lutess. Yes. Lutess, I wonder why that is. Odd.
Madame Lutess, I have read all your books on the sciences. Mama says it's not a fit occupation for a lady, but I think she's jealous of our cleverness. Is it true that only you are allowed to visit the girl in the tower? If the lamb is lonely too, I should like to meet her, as we would have much in common. Warmest regards, Constance.
Cool girl.
What the?
No, for sure, the fire's mark AD. And we don't have AD. Unusual. Oh, thank God we finally reached an auto save point. Right, well, that's gonna have to be all for me for this first part. I think I have fairly fully fixed the frame rate issue. Before, every now and again, it would only drop to like 5. From 60 to 5. It's very annoying. But yeah, so that's gonna be all for me for now. But here we're gonna have to start. Just think it, and as always, keep calm and carry on. A good day.